If you lived in the time of Muhammad, would you allow your mother, your sister, or your daughter to engage in muta?
My sister and my daughter is sleeping with another man without marrying him, even temporary. That would be a really wrong thing to do.
There you go. You did not give the context of war, did you? Did you? No, you. Correct? Yes or no?
Make your answer.
Yes or no?
Answer!
The thing is, your alternative is Islam.
No.
Your alternative is
Let's give it to her.
Is that the solution Islam gives for the desire of men in this society?
You are implying that Muhammad was a sinner because he had more than one wife. But nowhere in the Bible you can establish
ten
that marrying a more than
Ten commandments, yeah? What is one of the Ten Commandments? Do not commit adultery. What is the other one?
Who's denying that?
Do not covet your neighbor's possessions.
That is not the argument.
That includes wife.
That's not the argument.
So if you have more than one wife, you're committing adultery. Don't you get it?
According to who? According to the New Testament,
yeah, that's really judging by his own standards. How many wives do you have in the Quran?
In the Quran, Allah has given us permission to marry two, three, or four. But if you can't justice,
how many did Muhammad marry?
I'll answer you that. I'll answer you that, brother. You didn't get me on that. Show me where Allah says you can't marry more than four in the Quran, or even Hadith. Anywhere it says you can't marry, is Allah just giving the
so
example.
So you can't marry more than one.
So you can marry more than one.
No. What I'm saying that there are scholars saying that. Shabir Ali.
There are
scholars saying that Allah never say you can't marry more than four. What Allah says?
Does that mean he can
marry two, three, four? If you can't,
five, six, seven.
It doesn't go. It could have go to 100.
So it's four.
No, what I'm saying.
So it's four.
No, he doesn't put limit on that. He's just giving example. Marry two, three, four. If you can't do justice,
how many did Muhammad marry then? How many? Muhammad married?
Muhammad Sassan married about 9 to 11.
So why did he go against his own revelation?
Fair. Okay. Now you studied this thing, yeah? About this verse, yeah? Now you show me when this verse was revealed, how many wives Muhammad Sassan already had? Did you work it out?
Okay,
when this commandment came, how many wives did he already have?
It's a deviation.
No, it's not. What I'm saying to you, let's say for the
failed
because Quran came in 23 years, yes? So Surah Nisa, I think it came in Medina. Now, is it possible that Muhammad SAW, when this verse came, he already had 9 or 10 wives already?
Let me finish my point.
Then Allah said, do not marry more than 4. Now, what option?
Did he say more? No, he said, I'm
going by what you're saying.
Let
me make my point. Let's say for the sake of argument, Allah says don't marry more than 4. Yeah, even he doesn't say that. He says marry 2, 3, or 4. If you can't do justice, marry only 1. Never say you can't marry more than 4. Let's say for the sake of argument, he's saying can't marry more than 4. And Muhammad SAW already had 9 or 10 wives. Now he has two options here. Keep 4 and give 6, divorce to 6 of them. But remember one thing. Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was the leader and he was a prophet. And his wives were the mothers of the believers. Since he had a status as a prophet, so does his wife had a status up as a wife of the prophet. Now if he let them go, so what he's doing, he's degrading them. Now they are available for other men. For example, if the king gave a divorce to the queen, then she's going to marry somebody who's a subordinate. So they're degrading that queen. She's going down. So Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's wives, they were already mothers of the believers. So it's not suitable for them to he divorce them and now they go degrade. Did you work that out? It's possible that he already has wives, so he didn't give them divorce because it wasn't reasonable.
Just two things I want to touch on. First of all, okay, Allah, having full knowledge, would have known, okay?
Yeah.
Is that the first thing? Allah would have known that he's going to give a command, but you can only have 4 wives, okay? So, if this is, because what we claim as Christians, we believe that God's law, which is that, you know, just one man or one woman, is eternal, it's universal, it will never change, okay? So if Allah knew that he was going to give Muhammad, his prophet, his wife, going to be on this high status, why would he not give him a revelation from day one and say, you know, Muhammad only married four wives? That's number one, okay? Rather than all this confusion about how many wives. Number two, if you, okay, let's take an example, you're a thief, you're stealing, okay? All right? And then Allah commands you to says that thou shalt not steal, okay? You shouldn't steal. Would you say, well, you know, I've been stealing all this time, so I'm just going to continue stealing? Or would you drop the theft and obey God? What you seem to be saying is that Allah, rather than obey God, okay, he just continued on having sex with wives and perhaps he even had more wives. But the point, yeah, Muhammad, yeah. Sorry, Muhammad, yes. But the point
is, you don't know for sure after that verse. The point
I'm making is that if he really,
because there's a verse in the Quran, Allah says you can't have more wives.
Abbas
commanded him not to have more wives.
Let me finish my point. The point is that if he really wants to keep the law, and especially if he's the role model, he's the example to others to follow, yeah, then he ought to be doing what he says he receives revelation from himself. Otherwise, he's a bad role model.
So do as I say. No, no, no. Do what
first
I
of all,
do.
First of all, we establish that going against the commands of God is a sin. Yes,
which he did.
No. You can't prove it. After that, how many wives he had?
It doesn't matter. In his lifetime, he had more than nine wives.
Okay.
Period.
Can I answer? No.
The Quran says, let me read this. He made a command.
I know, but you say,
if you fear, Surah 4, Ayah 3,
yeah,
if you fear that you may not deal justly with the orphans, then marry women that you like, two, three, or four, full stop. Not ambiguous.
Is it full stop? Is it full stop in Arabic? In Arabic, is it full stop there?
Brother,
read us. No, seriously, I'm just saying that full stop,
brother,
when Allah revealed it in Arabic, does it say full stop and then the next sentence start?
He doesn't say five.
So why?
He doesn't say six. So it stops at four.
No, Allah is just giving an example.
Yeah, it stops.
You want five wives, don't you? You want five. How many wives you
want? You want that. But if you fear, watch this. If you fear that you may not treat them fairly, then marry only one or your slave women. So did Muhammad treat them equally? That's one question we're going to ask you too.
Why you be aborigine?
Muhammad never
Abraham, how many wives
is he
married?
Let me answer his question.
Answer his question.
Thanks very much.
According to the Bible,
answer his question.
Abraham, they marry women. More women.
In what school?
None.
None of them.
None.
What's that?
None more than four. So it's set at four is the maximum. Right?
So you know it's false. You're trying to deceive us.
No. Look, I heard the argument made by a scholar.
Shabir
Ali. Shabir Ali is a part of the scholar.
Shabir Ali. What about Shabir Ali? I don't get it.
Does he have a tafsir?
What about he's not a faqih, is he?
Exactly. So you're deviating. Oh, you're trying to deceive
Let me answer your question. What did you say? I forgot what he said because you were just making the point. What did you say in the beginning? The God is all knowing.
People, they don't know.
Why he didn't
you don't know about God.
Sir, can you
don't know
your
God. You're talking about women.
Can you respect
he's talking
your
kind of
respect.
Respect. Your brother?
Don't stop too low. This is my people. I know them. They don't know anything about religion. You go to church, you drink alcohol, you dance all day long, you close your eyes. If you close your eyes and you hear it with music, how can you study Latin? That's why I'm not joking. It's my people, black people. They go church, drink wine, they close their eyes and they dance. Basically, they close their eyes and ears.
Brother, you ask me a question. Let me
they,
answer.
They go.
This is what he's saying.
And they come back with nothing.
You have.
I'm going to address your point. You said if Allah is all knowing, why he didn't reveal that verse before he married more than four?
I want to address the point.
It's a very good point. Very good question.
So he's that perfect role model, Muhammad.
He is. No doubt.
So he has all his wives. What is for you as a Muslim?
As a human being, he's not perfect model for angels.
Okay.
Nobody. For human beings, is the perfect model because the way we live life. Let me address this point first. So you say why Allah didn't reveal in the beginning? First of all, we need to understand that Allah, in His wisdom, He knows the right timing for the right verses.
Not the wrong timing.
No. But Allah has revealed the verses for the alcohol as well. For alcohol as well. And when they were in Medina, so then alcohol becomes banned.
Okay,
So if you this is how you understand the Quran.
Let's go with the wives.
Okay, I'm going to make you understand easy for you what is easy for you in Christianity. You say if his God is all knowing, why he didn't establish something in the beginning which is right? So my question, I put it back to you.
if Jesus was going to die for the sins of the world, why God didn't send straight away after Adam, Jesus was the next man, come, right after Adam, before he even had children, so he died for the sins of the world. So when the world took to come, they follow, believe Jesus. Why God didn't send Jesus, which was the right thing, in believing in him? So the question back to you as well, you understand what I'm trying to say? If God is all-knowing, yes, so why God sent Jesus so many thousands of years later?
Okay, but you're deviating. Let's talk about the wives.
Because
you're
saying if God is all-wise, why he didn't send the verses before
he
married more than
let
four?
Let me read this verse, yeah?
Okay.
Do you understand what the point I'm trying to make?
He actually gave it to us in the Bible first, about marrying one wife and one woman. Watch this, Genesis chapter 2, verse 23 to 24. This is now bone of my bones, flesh of my flesh. She shall be called a woman, for she was taken out of a man. This is why a man leaves his father and mother and is united to his wife, and they become one flesh. That's the premise he gave us in the beginning. So if anyone disobeys
that,
no, he never changed it.
Okay,
when if anyone disobeys that, yeah, they're sinning.
Correct me if I'm wrong. When Jesus told people, when the Pharisees, Jews came to him, he says, what do you think about one man and one wife? And he's, Moses let us give divorce to the women.
Yeah, because of what was the reason?
No, I know.
Because
of the people, isn't it?
No,
because
what did he say?
Let's read.
And understand
why then they asked, did Moses command that a man give his wife a certificate of divorce and send her away? Jesus replied, now listen carefully. Moses permitted you to divorce your wives because your hearts were hard, but it was not so from the beginning. I tell you, anyone who divorces his wife, not wives, wife, singular, except for sexual immorality and marries another woman,
another point I'm
commits
here.
Adultery.
Well,
so
on whose
wife.
Permission did Moses permit people
even you don't
to
understand
give
what you're talking about.
On whose permission?
Their
Moses
hearts.
Was a prophet of God.
You see,
the sin that Moses let people to do open sin, even because of the people.
Verse,
so he changed the commandment
similarity.
Of God because of people. No.
This is example.
I'm saying that God, over time, he abrogates his things.
If you divorce a woman,
he never abrogated.
He
didn't abrogate
it. Abbas, he didn't abrogate it. He said, listen, it was
it's not singularity. That's the way we speak.
However, the only way
that's
he committed
not
how we
speak.
It
nothing to do with singularity.
It's because these
people's
hearts were hardened. They were just, you know, they were
callous. They're not responsive to God.
And so do you understand that he didn't
why something it? Sin like that Moses let people do
let
that?
Me ask
why move
let
Moses
me ask a question.
Do you see,
there
are
many,
you see why you're struggling?
This is naive. This is naive.
Because you can't
deal with your issue. You're trying to flip it onto the Bible.
I'm just showing you the flip side.
No, but you're showing.
I'm just showing the mirror.
No,
so you see yourself. What the complaint you have about Islam, it goes back to you as well.
Are you saying that
Moses... Abbas, what they're talking about, nothing to do with singularity.
Wait,
you are naive.
Bro, please.
I'll give an example. That's why you
don't want to talk to you.
You close your ears. You don't know. This verse nothing to do with singularity. For example, if I'm your bodyguard and you see a person, let me finish.
I am your
bodyguard. I'm standing if you don't get your
boss.
If you see a person, let me know. If you say so, if I see two, would I keep quiet or tell you?
He doesn't understand.
That's why this verse means if you divorce a woman or two or three.
Okay, that's what I mean.
You're talking about Muhammad's morality.
So I just have to go in 5 minutes
to
do my prayer.
Good question. So Muhammad allowed mutah, temporary marriage, right?
That's right.
Now, if you agree with Muhammad, if you lived in a time of Muhammad, would you allow your mother, your sister, or your daughter to engage in mutah?
If they will to. Never It's not a force on any woman.
No, no, but would you be okay with
it? It's not a force on any woman.
Would you be okay with it?
What's that?
If your mother, your sister, or your daughter wanted to engage in mutter, would you be fine with it?
It's a very good question. But I'm saying the Muhammad.
No,
they were women.
I said if you lived at the time,
they were women. They were women who were doing it for the sake of money, maybe some benefit. I'm answering your question, but I don't think it's a fair question.
No, you said Muhammad. You see, he doesn't want to condemn Muhammad.
This code,
in your heart,
nothing to do with singularity.
Because you want to answer your question, let me address the way I look.
What did you say? You can't marry.
I say this. Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam knew in the time of his time, people were going for the long time in the wars and all that. And then he knew the adultery is a sin.
Yes,
zina is a sin.
Okay.
So he say, okay, if you find women, maybe you fall in love with whatever. If you find the marry with them temporary marriage because you have wives at home.
Okay.
So you. In that sense, in extreme sense, you're allowed.
That's not every.
No.
I didn't but ask if that, you allowed.
So
I
you asked me a question. If I am a brother of that woman who was married
daughter.
To them,
so
you're implying their husbands and their fathers, they were happy with that.
No. I'm asking you if you live there and your daughter or your mother.
The
or your
marriage.
Sister wanted to engage in mutter, would you be happy?
No, I wouldn't.
Why wouldn't you?
Let me ask you, would you be happy with your daughter?
Let me tell you why.
I say if my, for example, my sister or my brother or my, oh sorry, my sister or my daughter, if they marry with like that people, knowing that it's not a sin what they're doing, they're marrying that man. For temporary, they're marrying. It's not sin they're doing, but I would say it's not what I prefer. It's not what I endorse.
But if you don't prefer,
but I would know that that would be allowed. I knew that would be allowed, but I will not be personally happy.
So you're condemning Muhammad.
What Muhammad?
But you have different.
He gave the perfect answer.
What I'm saying is, if my sister and my daughter is sleeping with another man without marrying him, even temporary, that would be really wrong thing to do.
There you go.
That would be wrong. So if
he's sunny.
Okay. If they're marrying with that man for 1 month or 1 week, whatever, at least it's a nikah, let's say it's allowed.
That's prostitution. No.
Wait, let me finish before you answer. Wait, because you have different.
No, we don't. We agree here. Hold on. Let me explain something to you. If you check the divorce rate of Christian countries, your marriages are damn temporary.
That's the reality of life.
Don't judge the religion by the people, by the scripture.
Let me finish. You're on a point.
Oh my gosh. Have some patience. Okay. What my point is, when you have what you call temporary marriage.
Okay.
That's not what its name is. Okay? You've called it that. So, hold on. That means pleasure. Okay? That's what it means.
Is it abrogated now? Is it allowed?
No. I've stopped going off subject. You called it temporary. No.
Okay, what would you define as mutter?
You said if it's abrogated, that's another subject, but if it's abrogated. I'm saying no, it's not. It's perfectly halal, but let me explain your conception when you approach the subject. I'm saying when you call it temporary marriage, I'm saying to you, even the marriages that you consider to be non-temporary are clearly temporary. So what I'm saying to you, I'm explaining. Let me finish.
Let me finish.
What is wrong with you?
You're on a premise. You're on a shaky foundation, and you want
to
build on that.
Every time I'm trying to talk, you interrupt me. Right, let me talk to you. Right. What I'm saying to you is, if you called it timed marriage, i.e. when you get into the relationship, there's an agreed upon time. That would be more accurate. Do you understand? In other words, it can be for 10, 20, 30 years. Yes or no?
But you don't agree the time beforehand, so I know.
No. Listen to what I'm saying.
Yes.
In what you're calling temporary marriage, mutter,
yes,
the agreement can be for 10, 20, 30 or 40
Let's
years.
Let's stay with three days.
No. Listen to what I'm saying to
you. Yeah, I know. But why are
you
going
would
to
we
there?
Stay yes. with what you want when it extends but all the way
Let's
over?
Let's cover all circumstances, okay, not just the long term.
No. I should bring you back. Let me finish, Robert.
Okay.
I'm saying to you, you've given the 3 days.
Yes? So let's start with 3 days. Okay. Up to how many? 90 years.
Okay.
Yes? Right. Now, what I'm saying to you is, do you agree if we followed your policy, which is this is the only legitimate way to have sex? Yes? What happens to the people that have sex outside of marriage, according to your rule of law?
They're condemned by God.
So, on the state system, what happens?
And the state, nothing.
What do you mean nothing?
What, in terms of if they're married?
Listen, no, listen to the question. Listen to what I'm saying to you. If you only have your version of marriage as the only option, and you have a proper...
You're Christian.
Within the Christian, yeah. Yes. You're Christian.
Yes. One man, one woman.
One man, one woman. And not only one man, one woman, but also the point and principle I'm saying is that this is the only legitimate way, according to you, to have sex.
Yes?
Right. According to you. So you're not saying that the timed marriage is an option, correct? You don't believe in that.
You can't agree to for 3 days.
Well, I'm just saying, this is what you said.
Right. We agree, yes.
Right. So I'm saying to you, if the people, for instance, there are some people in society, for instance, that have come out of a marriage, that have been divorced, but they're not ready to jump back into such a serious thing, but they have natural sexual desires. Couldn't they not say, you know what, I just want to go into this thing for a year and see, well, let me finish and see how it goes. And then after the year, I say, you know what, I want to extend it for 2 years. Wait, and keep going.
No,
what my point is many
let me 200%
finish. What is wrong with you people?
Wait, I was helping you.
You asked the question. A long way to this thing.
By the time we finish, we're going to say no. So you're just wasting time.
Brother, you're not paying attention.
We are going to say
no. Brother, I'm not saying I don't want you to. What I'm saying is, if you let me finish, then when you say no to all of it, then I have a response to that. So stop interrupting.
Go on.
So what my point to you is if you're saying that this is the way of God, for instance, you're basically saying that there is no way of solving the problems of this issue of what you would call in the Bible and Christianity illegitimate children, correct? And fornication, correct?
There is a way.
How?
But answer the question. So would you be happy with your daughter or your mother bringing a guy?
My mother's married to my dad, so stick with the daughter.
If you lived in the time of Muhammad,
okay,
and they said, there's this man,
yep,
I want to have a temporary contract with him,
yep,
for 3 days,
yep,
would you be happy with that?
3 days? I mean...
You see?
Stop.
Why is everyone having to think about
it? You're not paying attention. I'll tell you why.
I'll tell you why.
No, it's not let me think about it.
Don't give us what
you said. What's wrong with you people?
That's what he said, though.
Can you not shut up?
You're not answering. You said you want to ask from us. We gave you a straight answer.
No, you never.
But you're what? But you're not giving us a straight answer.
Yes or no? If you be quiet.
I'm going to elaborate.
If you be quiet.
Yes or no, then elaborate.
Right, I'll talk to you.
Yeah, yes or no, elaborate.
You said 3 days. You did not give the full hadith, did you? You did not give the context of war, did you? Did you? Nor you, correct? Yes or no?
Make your answer.
Yes or no?
Answer!
In warfare, right, that is what you should ask me. In the same circumstance that they were in at the time.
Okay.
As the option, let me finish. Let me finish. Let me finish. Because the people, oh my God, they don't know the context. If it is wartime, where you have testosterone-filled soldiers, which have the option to follow your way of raping children, which is what you Christians do when you go to Iraq, Afghanistan.
You're a tangent and you're lying.
Don't talk about Christianity.
Christians don't do that.
Just focus on this question. We're not talking about Christians. Yeah, don't talk about what Christians would do. Just focus on the topic itself.
So hold on. Is the topic not what you're presenting against what I'm presenting? Yes or no?
I'm asking you, what's in your scripture?
Wait, stop.
Not people.
Stop.
Your scripture versus our scripture.
Hadith, calm down. What I'm saying to you is
very simple. Your authoritative source.
What is wrong with this guy?
Authoritative.
Stop, you're not answering. I'm not answering.
No, you're not.
Straightforward, all I've asked you to do is give the full context. Have I not asked that?
Give the context.
And my answer was, yes, within the context, as opposed to raping women. Because that's what has happened throughout history with soldiers and currently by your Christian soldiers in Iraq. Wherever you lot go, you don't practice mutter, do you? And you kill them.
Just to confirm, in the context, you'll be happy with your mother or your daughter or your sister.
You asked me in the time of Prophet Muhammad. Yeah, confused.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. If you live then, I'm just confirming.
Yes,
I want you to pay attention.
I'm just reading behind closed doors.
Listen, I want you to pay attention.
I'm just reconfirming the point.
I want you to pay attention.
You can't dominate. He's heard your question. You've made it.
Why are you speaking for him?
Because you're confused. We're all in a conversation. You just butted in just now. So we're all talking. So what I'm saying to you is,
go ahead.
You've made your point very clear.
What's my point?
He wants to reaffirm, is this what you mean?
Okay.
So take it away.
So because we've had conversations before, and we have civilized conversations, don't we?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah.
And we share information very well, don't we? Mm-hmm. All I've asked for you to do is to give context. Is that unfair? Okay. Is that unfair of me to say give the full context?
He did. But I'm just asking you.
Listen to what I'm saying. Yes. Is that unfair of me to ask you to give the full context?
No, it's not unfair.
Exactly.
But he did.
So what I'm saying to you is, if you ask me, for instance, if there is no war, and there is an option for loads of handsome men to marry on what you call permanent marriage, and they choose mutter, I would not like it. But your problem you have is, it's not just the man, it's the woman as well. So why you got this bias? The woman can choose that as well. The woman can say...
I'm just asking you a question. Yes, it can work both ways.
Whose choice is it? I'm saying to you, if you lot have daughters, do you have a choice of who they marry?
No.
Right, so what can you do about it?
But I'm asking you, would you agree with it? That's what the
agree.
Question was.
Right, so
would you be happy with it?
Okay, I personally would not be happy if the option was not outside of a war situation. Okay. So for instance, let me finish.
But you'd be happy in a war situation. Okay.
So in a war situation, as opposed, and I want you to listen, as opposed to those soldiers raping girls.
Okay.
So they say, you know what? These women say, I know these guys are horny and testosterone.
But you're using a straw man.
I'll tell you why.
Because if we're talking about Islam and Christianity, nowhere does Jesus encourage you or allow you to go and rape children.
No,
so what you're talking
about...
Where
are you getting that from? This is what you claim.
No, what I'm saying. Listen to my point. Because we're talking about Islam. So if you're talking about Christianity, for example,
both.
If we're talking about both, Jesus doesn't say. Jesus advised people to control their urges.
Yeah.
If you can't control your urges, have a wife.
Right.
You understand?
Okay.
Not right.
Jesus doesn't say, okay, then go and rape people. Okay. That's a straw man.
Brilliant. No, you're not getting the point.
Yes.
This is what...
You're saying to avoid something else.
Please understand where I'm coming from. I'm saying one of the reasons of which... I don't know if you remember, Bob said to me to come back to Christianity. I'm going to tell you one of the reasons why Christianity should not be an option for anybody. And that is because you do not have the solutions to the problems of mankind. Do you understand? And this is a perfect example, because we live in a society where fornication is preferred over marriage. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes.
Predominantly, is fornication preferred over marriage? Tell me yes or no.
That's according to who? I don't understand.
I'm saying in this society we live in England. Wait, brother. In this society we live in.
What's the point you're making?
Just answer honestly. Yes or no?
No, I don't understand
fornication.
Your question.
Listen, in this society, do you not hear statements where they say marriage is just a bit of paper?
Okay. Yes, the reason we're asking
I'm saying solutions.
Hold on.
I'm talking to this guy.
What is your solution?
Right, brilliant. This is what I'm saying to you. I'm saying that if you go along with your either restrain or get married principle, then what you have is simply this. A lot of horny youngsters that are allowed through their access of their mobile phone, seeing all kind of porn material, etc. So when they're growing up and their hormones are racing, what is their first example? Porn. The girls are doing the same. So all these young little 12-year-olds and so on, all having sex, doing all kind of things.
Can I respond to that?
Let me just finish, sorry. I'm saying mutah, so-called temporary marriage, is a way in which those youngsters can have a unity together under the legitimacy of the Most High. As opposed to you lot saying, no, you must get married under law and paper and this whole...
Can I respond?
Yeah, let me respond.
The Bible is very clear.
Right.
Yeah?
That you're allowed to rape children.
No.
Brother, you said you can let him speak. Stop, let him speak, man.
Let me tell you, when you said about the Bible, not Jesus didn't teach rape, yes? I want to respond to that because that's where I was coming in there, but go ahead.
Okay, but you can say it after I said that.
No, no, no,
you can just say it.
You're allergic, you can't control it.
No, 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 I can.
Galatians chapter 5, 22.
Right.
It starts with love, ends with self-control. The fruit of the Spirit.
Amen.
So when you come to Christ, you talked about little teenagers, adolescents having their urges, they're horny, porn and everything. This is why Christianity is not lived by your own strength. It's lived by the strength of God. He comes in, all he asks you to do is surrender your heart to him and he will give you the power to control your urges because he knows how you feel. That is why one of the fruit of the Spirit is self-control. He gives you that control. So if you're saying the reason why you don't want to come to Christianity because you don't have an answer. You said you don't have an answer to this. We do have an answer.
Come to Christianity.
Come to Christianity, taste it first, and you will have the control of the Spirit. Whatever happens in society, whether they elevate fornication or not, God will give you the power to control your urges.
How long does that power last for?
Hallelujah. What do you mean?
How long? Listen.
Until you die, you still have it.
I want to ask you a little question.
Do you understand my answer?
I want you to respond now.
So why are you not coming to Christianity?
No, wait, I'm going to ask.
Why are you not coming to Christianity?
I'm going to tell you why. Please don't interrupt.
Because
when I used to go to church, and all these people were talking about their Holy Spirit, and their holiness, and their holy that. Unfortunately, the unholy spirit was right there beside them because they were committing fornication while the unholy spirit was upon them.
We don't care about people out there.
Of course,
we know people do that.
You're not listening. I'm saying to you, when you are claiming that this holy spirit comes into them and they do this and surrender themselves, I said, how long does it last? Because my point is,
forever.
Wait, because if these people have the holy spirit from Sunday, I don't know, whatever day, and to another Sunday for a couple of months, then they get the weakness. Then they fornicate. I'm saying what happened to the Holy Spirit?
No, they don't fornicate. I'm a Christian. He's a Christian.
Are you
saying? When we're tempted, when we're pressurized, we don't give in to sin.
Oh, so the one who do have the
power. No, we do have the power. We do have the power to overcome Jesus because Jesus Christ gives us his spirit.
Listen to my question.
We are able to do that.
That's not responding to what
the
I'm saying.
The thing is, your alternative is Islam.
No.
Your alternative is Islam. Let's give it to them. That's not an alternative.
You see how they tried to divert. When I was at church, and I know this still happens, it's not like just when I was at church. People that have surrendered to God, they've stopped drinking, they've stopped smoking, and all these fornicating. And that lasts for a couple of months, or even a year, and they're back into it. So that's
what does the Bible say about that?
Let me finish. I'm saying to you, when you have a solution, and you're telling me that God, the almighty power, comes into you, and it's a temporary solution. That's temporary marriage. Temporary marriage is much better.
I told you
no, it's not.
He's my brethren.
What I'm saying to you, my brother.
This is what I'm saying. So they have the we have temporary marriage. They have the temporary Holy Spirit. And then the temporary Holy Spirit.
You're lying.
We're telling you.
You're lying.
We are Christians.
Yes, we are.
I am telling you a personal experience.
Oh, no.
We give you personal experience.
Yeah, but deal with me. No,
let's deal with
you. Would you want to take on?
Amen.
No, I don't want to attack you. I'm just saying your personal experiences, whenever you've had, let's say, a temptation to fornicate, you would
never
say,
did it.
Let me So you're saying the Holy Spirit came to you or in you and caused you to refrain and go left or right of fornication, correct?
Yeah, self-control.
You're saying it's the Holy Spirit.
It's the Holy Spirit.
Because someone might say meditation. Bro, listen. Somebody might say I meditated, I've done something else. But you're saying it's the Holy Spirit, correct?
Yes.
So I'm saying, are you saying that those people that said it's the Holy Spirit that is keeping them from all these sins, but then they end up doing them, has the Holy Spirit left them? Are they not Christians? What is the deal there?
The fruit of the Spirit says self control.
Okay.
There's an element of you doing the control and Holy Spirit helping you. Yeah?
Yeah.
Holy Spirit is not someone who just helps someone who doesn't help themselves. So if you're not helping yourself, which is you sinning yourself, God's not going to come and say, oh, okay, let me do this for you.
Did you hear the scenario I give?
Yeah, I did. So if you are...
6 months of a year.
What about?
They make a New Year's resolution, right? They're going to give themselves to Jesus and God, and the Holy Spirit comes upon them the 1st of January. And then it comes to June the 30th, 6 months later, or the 1st of July, okay?
Yeah.
And they say, damn, the Holy Spirit has left me. They're now fornicating, smoking, and drinking.
No,
listen, I'm giving an example and scenario like you gave me 3 days. This is a perfect example of reality, I'm asking you personally. Is that true that some Christians, what they call backslide?
Well, but people can talk
yes
by them.
Yes or no?
Yes, but then people can talk with their mouth, because then you should look at the steadfast Christians, because what does it say? As they said, you will know them by their fruits.
Amen.
You understand?
So
when their people are steadfast,
so
you know these.
Let me read it for you.
No. I want you to tell me, what are these? Are they non-Christians? What are they? When they backslide,
yes,
and they give in to temptation, and the Holy Spirit's the Holy Spirit's power has failed them
themselves. Let me read.
Let me read what
the Bible says, because we don't want opinions.
Stop. I'm talking about reality now, not your opinions, right? I'm talking about reality.
The Bible is
real. I'm saying to you, realistic circumstances, which you know.
Yeah.
There are people that have been to church, they've got the Holy Spirit.
Brother, we're trying to answer.
Can we read scripture? Let me just answer this, then read it.
Answer this question first,
then read it, please, yeah?
Yeah, what's
so
your question?
Are they still Christians or not?
The scenario,
6 months later.
Wait, can I just ask everyone who's watching, who here would, no, but because he's making his case, but who here would allow their sister or their daughter to engage with a temporary marriage for 3 days?
Those who are watching, would you do that?
Why not mention the subject? Why would you not mention the context? Do you think that's evil?
Under any context. Let us say any context.
Under any context.
War.
Bro.
Okay. As opposed to raping.
Okay,
that is the best solution. As opposed to... All right, if men are under war, what's your solution?
Still.
No. What should they do?
Who disagrees? Show your hand.
Okay.
So we have the crowd here. No one agrees with your solution. No one agrees with your solution.
You've gone back and forth.
No, but I'm just asking.
You say no one. He's mocking you.
This is why you need to come back.
That's why you need to come back to Jesus.
Watch this, yeah? Watch this.
Please read this. Let me refute.
Blessed is the one who preserves under a trial, because having stood the test, that a person will receive the crown of life that the Lord has promised to those who love him. When tempted, no one should say, God has tempted me, for God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does he tempt anyone. Last verse. But each person is tempted when they are dragged away by their own evil desire and they are enticed. That is why they went and sinned, not because of the Holy Spirit.
Right.
You said it was
through the Holy Spirit.
No, you said it. June the 30th. You gave a 6 month period.
Not because of the Holy Spirit. I never said the Holy Spirit tempts you away. I never said that.
You said the Holy Spirit temporary.
You said the Holy Spirit temporary. I didn't say it tempts you. You know what tempting means?
I know that.
Meaning the power that you're bringing.
We know you didn't say that.
What the hell are you?
We know you didn't say
that. It's only manifested in a short period, then people backslide or whatever.
Right,
but that's because of their own evil desires. It's not because of the Holy
Spirit. You're not getting the point.
No, we are getting the point.
We don't get the point.
Listen.
If they accept it into them, you said that is your solution, and I'm saying it's failed. It's failed because 6 months later in the scenario, this Holy Spirit, the power of God according to you, left them, and they gave in to temptation. Where's the Holy Spirit?
So brother, I just want to correct this up, yeah? What do you understand what we just read here? Do you understand it?
I understood what you said. It's not quite directly related.
I want you to explain what we've just read here, because I think it's quite clear. I want you to explain it. Because right now we're just going in circles.
You're going in circles because you're dizzy.
But what did we? Where did we? What do you understand? What you just read?
What I understood from what you were saying is basically this: that the Almighty God has these people who He gives the Holy Spirit to, the power of God, and they restrain themselves through their own choice. If you choose good, you'll be supported and empowered by the Holy Spirit. When you choose to do evil, that will be sort of your personal choice of letting go of God's power or your covenant.
This is what you did.
No. You left.
You left the Holy Spirit.
This is what you did.
That's why.
You're the devil's in.
That's why.
You're the devil's.
I'm the devil's. We'll change the subject.
Wait, you said you left
Christianity because of that.
That's what you said.
You left Christianity because Christianity doesn't have a solution.
Solution?
For your urges.
For your
horny urges.
For your lust.
I'm saying to you, it
does.
That's
why I'm drinking. I never used to drink.
But you chose.
I never used to drink.
You chose.
You're not listening.
I'm telling you.
No.
It's not because of God.
Are you allowed to drink in Christianity?
It's because you chose to leave.
Right. Listen to what I'm saying to you.
I just need to ask a question to understand something.
Can I just say this first and then
answer? No.
I just want to clarify, please. All I'm saying is, you got it wrong. I didn't limit my reason for leaving to do with sexual urges. It was any solutions to the whole of society. No. I'm saying to you, that was one of the things.
Okay, that's a bad reason.
You're not listening. Let me say it again. I'm saying, as a person studying and looking for the truth, not only does Christianity not have a solution to the fornication, it doesn't have it in regards to drugs, alcohol, violence. It has no solutions to social problems, and therefore actually encourages sin.
We're just giving you the
right.
Okay, now, can I ask my clarification question? Am I right to understand?
No, practical and proper solutions. Please go ahead.
Am I right to understand that you were a Christian?
Sure, can you just do that? Just let me. Yes. Just go.
Can we get some space? I need to breathe right here.
You were a Christian?
Yes, madam.
And you decided to become a Shia Muslim?
No, but go ahead.
So he was a Sunni, then he became a Shia, right?
So you were a Sunni before?
Whoa.
Let me explain.
Do you want me to explain? No, and then you can go on that.
Can you just give me your order?
Yeah, I'll give you a background. Order, right. So I was a Christian raised in church, yeah? Then about 15, I started to study, yeah? So I was looking into Rastafarian, Hebrew, blah, 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 Hindu, everything. Various different things. I sort of left religion to a degree, was looking into atheism, all kind of different things. Then I converted to Islam at some point.
Yes? Islam, which one?
Sunniism. And then I sort of went through them, looking Sufism, this, the Abandi, Tabligh Jamaat, da 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 da. Salafi, Wahhabi, seemed to be the one that was the one with the proofs. But it had no spirit in it, and it was full of contradictions. I met a Shia brother, I looked at the evidence and so on, then I converted to Shia. That's the summarized.
Okay. So I'll just ask my basic question.
Yes, please.
As I was hearing, brother was reading James 1, and you saw the solution for man's desire is the muta marriage, which is in Islam.
Man's desire? What about the woman? And the woman got desire too?
No, but that's the subject. Dealing one by one.
Because you are man, brother.
For both.
Because you are man, therefore I am asking first man. Okay. I am quite happy to discuss position of woman in muta marriage as well.
Yes.
But can you just try to explain it to me?
Right.
Brother, I don't want to hijack your conversation.
Please do.
No, please.
You might make more sense. Go ahead. You and him.
So you think I will make more sense while, according to Islam, I don't even have intelligence because of my parents.
Exactly. Who says that?
Muhammad.
All right, go ahead.
So,
where did Muhammad say that?
Can you just try?
We don't want to deviate. We can show
okay, but you said it, so it's not deviation. If you say it, it's not me deviating, right?
Yeah. No, because you're saying
you keep interrupting. That's why.
You're saying
I said that her and him. Sorry, Hatun and the brother here might be.
But I don't get this one.
But you said to him interrupt, and I'm saying I appreciate your interruption.
So, go ahead. Can you just try to explain it to me?
Yes.
This well-detailed muta marriage for
right.
us.
Go ahead.
And how can it be the solution for the sins in the society, especially Million. For the desires of man?
Thank you very much. I told you she's better than you two. She asked a proper question. She's going to get a proper answer. Thank you very much. Now, when you have, excuse me, don't interrupt. You said about the muta marriage. Let's not call it temporary marriage. Let's call it timed marriage. Because that's the main factor in difference, where you stipulate your time. Which can be, as the brother said, from 3 days to 90 years.
Okay. Okay. Just a moment. Sir, what's your name?
Pepperboy.
Okay. So.
You don't know his name?
Have you met
him? I thought you... Maybe are
you
serious? No. What the hell? Incident. It's hard to... It's a big boy. He's crazy.
Sir, let's just focus.
Yeah,
so,
I'm very focused.
He wants to... He's married, okay? He
wants not yet. Yeah, great. Sorry. Go ahead.
He wants to have Muta marriage with him, okay?
Oh, sugar. She's hinting, bro. Go ahead. I don't think...
You laugh at your own jokes.
No. I don't think that's a good example.
Because you see how ugly it is.
No, because it's mutter with you. It's not you doing mutter with him. It's both of you doing it.
Okay. Just let it finish.
So, he asked me to have mutter marriage with him. And then we said that marriage is going to go for 8 days, okay? And am I right to understand? He needs to pay me for the pleasure he received from that sex for 8 nights, sir.
Uh-oh.
So that is the solution Islam gives.
Let me know when you finish the question.
Yeah. Is that the solution Islam gives for the desire of men in this society?
For that lustful desire.
Right. Have you finished? Can I answer now? Yes. Okay.
She's about to drink.
You're not paying for the desires because the woman is also engaging in the mutter marriage.
He is paying for the pleasure, not the desire.
He gets from the woman. So let me explain that in the normal permanent marriage that you call it, does he not give her a dowry as well?
Yeah. So
in both cases, if you want to put it that way,
I'm comparing.
Yeah.
How many times do you pay dowry to the woman? Once before the marriage.
Yes.
Okay. How many times he pays me for the pleasure he received from that sex? How many times?
As many times as you do the contract.
Yeah.
It's still marriage.
It's a joke.
Go ahead. Yeah.
And you're trying to separate. That is the solution.
Yes.
To the society Islam offers force man desire.
Degraded to sex. Yeah. That's all it is.
Hold on. Yeah. This is what I'm saying. Wait.
So, let me just clarify something.
No, you didn't want me to interrupt. Hold on. But then he talks.
Wait, if you're married, if you're married,
yes.
Can your wife go and do mutter?
No.
So it's not, there's no equality.
It is for man.
So then that causes issues in itself. Then
it's only for man.
It's only for man.
You said it would solve society's issues, but then that would cause issues within itself.
Exactly.
Answer your question. Ask your question and let me respond.
Do you believe it would cause issues then?
Okay. I'm saying to you, all of it is there to solve the problem.
See what I mean?
I can't even bloody talk. I'm saying to you,
she's going to be now.
All the time that these religions, or when it comes, there are problems in society. So when you're talking about solving the problem, what are you heading for?
Jesus.
I'm saying to you, do you agree yours is about the hereafter? So you're not looking to solve problems on earth, are you?
Yes.
Answer that. I'm talking to you.
We're giving you the problem.
I'm talking. Why is it you can't trust him to answer?
Well, yeah, on earth as well.
Okay, so tell me what solutions you have to this problem, because it's practical now. Children have already now engaged from 13, 14 now with all of this.
No, you haven't.
Listen to what I'm saying. They've already started. So when they've already got into the habit of it now, the hormones are racing. You come and say, have the Holy Spirit, their hormones are still going. Holy Spirit don't stop your hormones, does it? Does it?
Yeah, but what your point is, in a sense, is a false equivocation. Because I can say to you, you go and do mutter, your wife gets angry and she goes and poisons you or something like that.
Stay with me.
There's a reaction.
Stay with, brother. No, stop. Oh my God. Why don't you stay with the example given? You're jumping everywhere.
Yeah, but you're...
Pay attention. Let me give a scenario. I respond to your scenario.
If you're not going to respond to my scenario, I'll just answer why. Because you're picking a situation and giving a scenario that you think it solved. But then you're throwing under the bus the other problems that it can also solve.
If you deal with this one, then we can jump to yours. Let me teach you now. If the subject matter is problem solving within society, do you not agree that me and you cannot go back into our past and change it? We can't.
Okay.
So therefore, as elders, we would like to change the younger's situation, correct?
Okay, fair enough. Go on.
So this is why I use the example of the younger's, because when you get them to, let's say your solution, the Holy Spirit from young, rather than pornography from young, yes? Would you not agree if you get to them young with your, let's say, your Holy Spirit solution, it'll be much easier for them to continue and not have sex if they're in the Holy Spirit rather than porn teach them, correct?
Okay,
but yes
then,
or no? Yes
but,
or no?
But then if you
yes or no first?
Let's say yes, let's say yes. Well, what is
right.
your point?
So it's yes to getting there first. So now I'm saying is, now that they have already started en masse on this road of pornography, etc., and they're having sex, I'm saying to you, with your belief in Jesus and the hereafter, how does that solve the problem here? How does it practically do something?
Self-control.
Answer that question.
You keep saying self-control, but they're young.
Yeah. Issues with you. So they sleep with as many people as they want to, yeah? To fulfill their desires. What about things...
Why can't they sleep with one person in marriage?
Yeah, but they're unlimited. So they can have like one temporary contract, move to another
person. You're not listening. I'm saying with the supervision of the parents and society, community, you can have
with supervision? With this,
listen to what I'm saying to you. When I say supervision, meaning, you, instead of them sneaking around and having sex in the park or when parents are not home, I'm saying, once you know the society they live in, they're going to be having sex. I'm saying, this is how it is.
Okay.
Yes? So you can either come together and say, right, this is going to happen. Just in case a kid comes along or whatever else, we'll discuss it with you kids. And we'll say, right, this is the contract. Underneath the concept of a Most High God, which hopefully would lead in like an engagement towards
yeah, but what you're trying to do, you're trying to push it down your narrative. Yeah. I can say the same parents can get their kids and say don't have sex.
And what happens?
Be strong.
And they're doing it really. No, and it don't work. You're finished.
Because
you're finished. Because it don't work.
You don't
want
work.
It don't
work.
It would do. It would do. But you
give us a scenario.
I'm saying to you,
give us a scenario. You don't have a scenario.
I do have a scenario.
We have a scenario.
What's
a
scenario?
We are the personal scenario.
Exactly.
What, two people?
Perfect examples.
No, we are here.
Give me a percentage of Christians. Excuse me. Give me a percentage of Christians that have got this Holy Spirit thing and it lasted them whenever they made this covenant with the Holy Spirit. I've never
answered that question.
You really answered. Give me a percentage.
Can I
just
answer
that?
Jesus said, those who have ears.
No. Answer the question.
No one can answer
the question. Give me a
second.
Okay. No one knows. You don't know. Listen. Only God knows. If you're telling me God comes into you, how is it that God cannot give you that power to refrain yourself?
Okay. Well, answer.
Tag team again. You see what I mean? Every time you feel
bad.
Yeah, but you engage.
Yeah,
but you engage with us, so you're in.
You came to ask me. As I'm refuting you. Yes, no, I actually want to talk to him because we arranged to talk. Yes?
No.
Yeah, I'm saying to you, the subject matter is more my subject matter than anyone else. True? Mutter.
How do we know that?
No, he knows. Okay. You know that, right?
That I'm saying, your subject.
I'm saying if anyone should be talking about that subject, because I'm saying he, as a Sunni, might reject it, correct?
Okay. Yeah.
So who the hell should be really talking about it? Be honest.
Well, if you believe in it.
Exactly. Okay. Yes? There's no point me coming to you and bringing Catholic beliefs and you tell me, well, you can argue on their behalf.
Okay. Yeah? There's a lot of work, you know. How to make a
know, because your garbage don't work over here. Because your falsehood don't work.
Go on.
Please continue, Hartu.
So, while that is your solution, Muta marriage is your solution for the society.
As an option.
Allah gives that option as a solution.
Yeah.
So,
will you get a paper boy?
Is
he gone?
So you have to deal with us now. What do you think about that?
I don't mind. I mean, Hartoon has been trying to talk to me for a long while.
You have to deal with us now.
I think generally you're okay, but unfortunately he seems to not respect any... saying my experience.
Brother, God loves you and he died for you and we all love you.
Amen.
Don't deal with those kind of personal issues. No. You are wonderful, divide brother.
I'm saying that...
It doesn't work.
It's not divide and conquer. He asked me, am I happy? He asked me a question, am I happy to deal with you all now? And I gave him an honest answer and I said my experience with Hartoon and the brother here, is it them all? You asked me a question! How do you say your name?
Hartoon, make your point.
How do I say it? No, because I don't want to disrespect her. Go ahead.
She's got a question and we need to
go. Solution to the man's desire is the Muta marriage, okay?
I've already said, male and female.
I'm just going to make a point, okay? It cannot be men and female, because while I'm in Muta marriage, when he divorces me, okay, I have to still wait for certain periods to find out I'm pregnant or not.
Yep.
You don't have to go through that. You can just have the Muta marriage just the day
That's right.
you finish the Muta marriage.
And in non-Muta marriage as well, yes?
and you are complaining about...
And in non-Muslim.
Let me make my point. So you are complaining about, today our kids from age 13, 11 to God knows how many, they have sex outside of the marriage, they sleep around, all those kind of things. What is the difference between this brother to have a sex with someone who is 13 years old, only for 5 days, having that mutah marriage, having mutah marriage for 5 days, versus boys and girls to be friends, and then they have sex in their relationships outside of the marriage.
Okay.
For let's say how long goes their friendship. Okay. Only difference is he pays me every time when pleasure he receives.
Okay, hold on. Come on now.
You have to finish your point.
So how am I going to respond to you?
Hatun, continue, please.
Are you talking to me or the camera? Because you're answering your own question. Okay.
Am I looking at the camera?
No, but I'm saying you asked a question. You asked a question. And I wanted to respond, but you answered it, and you still want to continue.
So I would love you to give your comment on it.
That's what I'm trying to do.
I am very disturbed.
Okay.
The mutah marriage.
That's what I was trying to do. Can I give my comment? Can I give my comment now? To your scenario.
Sure.
I don't want to use him as an example because he's a Christian. So let's deal with the scenario which is more practical. So you have, let's say, 2 13-year-olds, a male and a female. They're at school. Let's say the parents have found out that these two have an intention and they're getting close, yes? And you said, what's the difference except you pay each time?
Right.
And the other one, you said, is that you just have sex without the pain, correct? That's what you said, yes?
Yeah, the teenagers.
Right. So the one way you have sex without the mutah marriage, you do not recite anything relating to the Most High.
Oh my Lord!
Is that your answer?
I haven't finished yet. Can I finish?
Wow.
In a similar way, when you get married, when you give your oath, in your marriage, what's the difference? Excuse me, don't interrupt. I'm saying when you get into the relationship, it is encouraging the two to try and do this, you know, fulfill their desires practically under the covenant of the Most High God. Whereas your fornication idea has never been accepted at all. So my point to you is, when you talk about, let's say, the Christian marriage, many other people have said, well, what's the difference? It's just a piece of paper. So I asked you the same thing. What's the difference? People live together.
Let me respond.
Please do.
Let me respond. First of all, can I just express how I am happy that you did not want to use Godwin as an example because he was Christian.
Yeah.
There is something in Christians and in Christian God makes men and women unique. We can't even use them in our examples, such as multi-marriages. There is something in that, okay?
You have concubines, right?
No, we don't.
Yes, you do.
No. I have come across
with them. You don't understand, I came to destroy the law or the prophet.
I did not come to destroy the law or the prophet. I came to fulfill.
How did you do it?
So excuse me, don't interrupt. Don't interrupt. Therefore, he stop and break the least of my father's commandments.
Don't do so.
And teaches men so shall be called least in the kingdom of heaven.
I am grateful. I was giving you a compliment. He made a point.
You asked me a question. I responded, then he interrupted.
No, she was answering. You forgot what she said.
What did she say then? What did she say?
Okay, Mama,
she was. What did she say?
What
did she say?
She was speaking about, she's so glad that I didn't use me as an example.
Because Christianity, and that's where you cut in. Yes, exactly. What did I say? Why are you cutting her off? And then,
Let her finish. I refuted her.
You can't.
No, you cut her off. You're rude.
In a sense, I am heartbroken, okay? Listen this carefully. That's my heart is breaking.
Unfortunately, you're not even allowing me to give you compliments.
I don't give compliments that often. If I were you, I would enjoy the moment. So, I'm going to give my compliment once again. thanking you that you say there is something in the followers of Jesus
that
they cannot be the example for the Mutamari. Yes. So thank you for that.
No, no, I didn't say that. I said him. I said him.
No, you said Christian.
I'm a Christian. You said
Christian.
Because I'm a Christian.
Because I'm a Christian.
I want you to pay attention. I know other Christians. Thank you very much.
Excuse me, sir.
I'll tell you straight.
Let her finish her point.
No, no, no. You see what I mean? But when he interrupts, when you jump in and he jumps in, I must let her finish. But you didn't let her finish, and he didn't let her finish.
Because you jumped in. I jumped in.
When you jumped in, because you jumped in with a lie, and I told you it was a lie.
We need to make him move very
soon. Hold on. So you're just going to talk and make your point, and I can't say anything back.
No, I'm just telling you, we are going to make him move very soon. Be very
well. I want to discuss concubines. Because I'm saying that's yours. That's in your book. So what's that? An inferior creature in your book.
What's wrong with you?
You don't want patience.
I'm talking about the Holy Spirit. You can't even wait for a lady to finish her point.
It's alright, guys.
Listen,
it's alright. I know Islam teaches. Yes. I'm not intelligent. Women are going to end up in hell because they get their monthly periods and they are not intelligent.
Where does it say that?
But that's
not how it works. What's that got to do with me? What the hell Sahih Bukhari got to do with me?
You were a Sunni once, wasn't you?
What Sahih Bukhari got to do with me?
Lay answer.
You were a Sunni once. You even refuted yourself.
So, as I expressed,
why are you mentioning Sahih Bukhari?
Go ahead to
lay answer.
As I expressed.
Yes.
The difference between mutual marriage and girls and boys to go out and have sex, of course, Christian secret is...
I missed that bit. Boys and girls too?
Boys and girls to go out and have sex outside of marriage.
Fornicate.
Of course, Christian scripture is completely against that.
Okay.
That's including mutual marriage. But I still can't see the differences. Besides, one of them is pain.
Prostitution.
And probably in one of them there is a love involved. I went out with Godwin, or there was a time and place I had affection for him. Through that affection, sex took place. Versus mutual marriage. Let's say mutual marriage for 3 hours.
Why not 4 years? Why are you using the smallest time?
Whatever, okay. Just
Does Quran give you 10 years
if you want, 20 years, why not?
Does Quran give you? Does Quran give you the certain amount of the time?
No,
it doesn't.
It varies.
It can be 3 hours.
Right. It can be 3 hours.
After three hours, you can marry like you lot
and get the girl
after 3 hours.
Yeah, but you just go around in circles. I need to talk as well. Am I going? Are you going to let me talk off you? You talking about Mutta or Talat? Which one are you talking about?
Don't you get the first in Mutta?
No.
You didn't know that? No, contract finished. That marriage finished. Okay, so our marriage is going to finish.
Hold on, you can renew it.
Godwin, I'm sorry, I know even this gentleman is angry. We cannot use Christians as an example for the Mutta.
That's good.
But, we agreed on one thing.
But I'm going to use you as an example. So, Godwin asked me to have a Mutta marriage.
No, you know what? Forget this, because you keep going on with your own example. No, forget that. No, how long the bloody point going to take? No, forget that. You've given a scenario before. You then explained and answered your own question. I then tried to interject with concubine, and now you're going again.
Excuse me. Hold on, wait.
I'm trying to talk. We all agree that Hartwina tried to just take over the whole thing and talk.
Let me respond. We're going to look away at concubine.
With her unjust, unholy spirit having Christians beside her. As I was saying now, unholy spirit, you have the unholy, the demonic spirit. I cast the demons out of you.
Allah sees you. Excuse me.
I was a Muslim in the Shaitan regime.
It is only Muslims who are scared that much. They even say, Satan doesn't touch me.
What are you talking about?
That's what you just said, man.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I am prophet.
Excuse me.
What you're saying.
Oh, you just said something in Arabic. And she just.
I want you to understand something. When I'm trying to have a conversation, I mean, maybe we need to time it so that you time 2 minutes, 2 minutes.
Because I'll do the time.
Right?
The time.
Okay, please do, please do.
No.
Please do. Yeah. She did. She wants to be oppressive.
She said we're
and she wants to talk. 2 minutes. Oh, here we go. Oh, do you say your bit and then make a move?
No, I'm going to.
Okay, I'll just say my bit.
What's your bit about concubines?
Simple as this. I'll just say my bit.
Look at that. Christians are meant to be concubines.
Very simple as this. According to, as I've read the scripture.
But I don't know how long you guys.
No, wait. We're nearly finished. In the Bible, it says, the Messiah says, think not that I've come to destroy the law and the prophets. I did not come to destroy but to fulfill. Therefore he that breaks the least of my Father's commandments and teaches men so shall be called least in the kingdom of heaven. Therefore clear cut is the Messiah saying that you have to acknowledge and follow the Old Testament and the Old Covenant as well as the one he brought.
We're on the grace.
Don't interrupt. Let me finish.
I haven't finished yet.
As I was saying, in the Old Testament, concubinage is all the way through.
Oh my God.
It is fully lawful.
Jesus break the Sabbath.
Here's the Bible.
I'm trying to
show us from the Bible.
He break the Sabbath.
Show us from the Bible.
I'm trying to talk.
And the unholy spirit has come. Christ of the full-time marriage. Please be gentle.
I was trying to. It's a diary. Do you have diary in your Bible? Yes, you do. Do you give your concubines diary? Excuse me, don't interrupt. If you have, throughout your Old Testament, concubinage, surely the all-knowing God was well aware that these women and girls were taken as concubines, and if your Almighty God saw it to be unjust, he would have outlawed it in your Bible.
You're not listening.
If they practiced it, and God didn't like it, just like when they practice adultery, he said, Why are you interrupting? I haven't finished my question without you interrupting. It's a very simple question, okay? So my question is very simple. What I would like to see is, since God was the all-seeing and all-knowing of the practice of concubinage wholesale throughout the whole Testament, which crosses about 4,000 years, let's cut it down to 3,000 years, okay? So 3,000 years, the all-knowing God watched these poor concubines abused by the Christian-type people, and according to them, excuse me, if your Messiah said it's okay, you're the same people as them.
Where did he say that?
Your Messiah said, "Did not come to this order." Oh my!
I haven't finished yet.
But don't lie though. Stop lying all the way through.
So hold on. So when she was lying, I tried to interject. You didn't like it, did you?
What did she lie about? What did she lie about?
Have you finished?
What did she lie about? So you're lying again.
You've interrupted.
He's lying about a problem.
I'm trying.
Okay, we can continue this debate next week.
Okay. Let's try and continue. My point. Hopefully, if we can continue next week, is simply this. I'm making this claim that the Almighty God was fully aware of concubinage. And if we look at concubinage through the modern day Christians, it would be very oppressive to those women. And since the Messiah said he did not come to destroy the law or the prophets, he came to fulfill, that would mean that the Almighty God saw those concubines abused and was happy to see it. And it's still lawful for Christians today. So therefore, concubinage is still part of the covenant of the Most High according to their own book, although they want to try and wiggle out of it.
Do you think it was a method because some people had such wealth and loads of other people had no wealth?
That's a separate subject, though.
It was a... No,
I hear you. Separate
subject. Back then, that's why they had lots of concubines.
That's fine, that's
I'm
fine.
Not agreeing with it.
No.
Separate subject. Because some people had that wealth.
You made statements. I'm going to respond to that, okay?
Please.
Just wrap up.
So.
Let's go.
Yeah, you wrap up. Don't let me answer. Go on.
When I came to join the conversation...
Sorry, are you Muslim?
Right.
I came and joined the conversation because people were looking solution for the sin in the society.
Because he can't greet you first. You know, you have to greet
him. Did I say how he was?
So people were looking for the solution for the sin in society.
Can you not hold it? I can't hear him.
Okay,
go on.
When I came and joined the conversation, people were looking for the solution sin in the society, mainly linked with the desire of man for the sex, okay? And solution, you came to the conclusion that Christianity doesn't give solution, Sunni Islam doesn't give solution, Shia Islam gives the solution for that. And solution was, one of the solution is the muta marriage, okay? Short-term marriage and every...
No, not short-term. Timed marriage, it's not short. It can be 90 years.
It can be 3 hours.
Right? So time, it can be, but it's not short. It's not, you're trying
to... It doesn't have to be 3 hours.
So it's timed.
It can be
don't
even
say short. That's not
15
true.
Minutes.
15 seconds. Right, but it's not limited to that. It can be 90 years.
So you're 13 year old.
Practically 15 seconds.
Well, maybe that's what Christian men, unfortunately, only last 15 seconds.
But the point is, you're lying. You don't do muta.
You
said
it's... I know, you're fornicating.
I'm just wrapping up, sir.
So now you're lying.
But be fair, though.
Now you're lying.
It's not short-term marriage. Is that a fair correction?
Okay, temporary marriage.
What temporary? Time.
Timeline, okay.
Thank you.
So, we can continue next week. I'm just going to wrap up.
Okay.
And I have seen here, it's not only you butchered Islamic scripture, it's not only you butchered Muhammad, also you butchered all your imams, 12 imams. It is sad.
Yeah.
Ali, Hussein, Hassan, all of them,
yeah.
Muhammad,
yeah.
Even Allah,
yeah.
Does not have any problem,
yeah.
With the Christian scripture and God of Christian scripture. Yet, you come to Speaker's Corner, and instead of defending...
You said scripture, right?
Defending or justifying,
yeah.
Muta marriage, you are bringing up the captives in the Old Testament.
The what?
Captives.
Captives.
Here's the difference.
No, but I don't understand where you're...
You don't understand because you're...
No, you said scripture. I didn't say scripture.
On the wall. Wait, this is a cop-out.
No, no, I said Christianity.
You do understand, but you're copping out.
Don't tell me, you don't... Listen, I'm
wrapping up, okay?
Okay.
I'm sorry that you are failing to understand my...
No, because you said scripture. I didn't say scripture. I said Christians, and I said
Christians
the Messiah.
Christians do follow the scripture.
No, you don't.
But
that was my point. I'm saying
no, but
that's
you
my
said
point.
Jesus
sir.
Fulfilled the law.
No, no, I
that
said
that is in the scripture.
That whatever fulfill means, it means
sir,
you still have to follow the Old Testament.
Do you know what the fulfilled law is?
No, but it was a practice that wasn't forbidden.
Law, you said
it wasn't forbidden.
You said fulfill the law.
Right?
It's not the law. So you're wrong.
Right, but it wasn't forbidden.
So this
was still allowed.
It had nothing to do with fulfillment.
Brother,
you're not paying attention.
No, you know.
You're not paying attention.
No, no, wrong.
Wait a minute.
He knows he's wrong.
Hold on. Did God know they were doing?
I listen to you, man. I'm wrapping up, just listen to me, and we will continue next week.
Okay.
So, while they are concubines,
yeah.
There is nowhere in the Christian scripture
yeah.
It tells us you pay for the pleasure you receive from the sex
from
to
the
concubines. Yeah. There is nothing like that.
Well, what did I get for it?
I am disturbed
so it's even
and
worse.
Heartbreaking,
yeah.
Heartbreaking
yeah.
That it's not only you are butchering your own scripture,
yeah.
You are even comparing that.
Well, what do they get? What do the concubines get? Tell me
yes,
what they get.
I'm gonna get.
Tell me what money. Yeah. What do they get? Benefits.
Yes.
Go ahead. Housing. When
you go to vote against your enemies.
Right.
Well, I'm not saying
and
now.
The Lord your God delivers them into your hands.
Yes.
And 10 captives. If you notice among the captives are beautiful women.
Yes.
And are attracted to her. You may take her as your wife. Bring her into your home. Make her shave her head. Trim her nails.
Oh my God.
Put aside the clothes she was wearing when you captured her.
Shave her head.
After she had lived in your house and mourned for her father and her mother for a full month, then you may go to her and be her husband.
Right.
And she shall be your wife.
Right.
If you are not pleased with her, let her go wherever she wishes. You must not sell her or treat her as a slave, since you have dishonored her.
Yeah, yeah,
that's so what they do.
How does shaving her head help her
mother? That's how they do the Jewish people. Okay. That's how they do them.
That's fine.
That's
fine. That's fine. But what I'm saying, I said concubine.
I said concubine,
and she went to another verse. She didn't mention the concubines of Solomon. She didn't mention the concubines of Abraham.
Did you mention?
I mentioned concubines.
Very, very disappointed.
She went with the Old Testament.
No. Concubines.
I am very, very disappointed.
As a captive, a wife.
What are they?
Not concubine.
What are they?
Not concubine. You see?
Unfortunately, I am very disappointed.
Where is that verse?
Deuteronomy 20, just one verse. Verse 10 to 14.
As you come to speakers' corner,
my intention was not to come and debate Christians. But now you
want a solution to society's sex.
You see what I've done to the Sunnis? If you look better than me now, it's over for you.
Why would you give me this verse? Cannot be solution for sexual sin. Because it is Islam
that brings the whole
law. Gives birth to the sexual sin.
No, it's not just that.
Discuss with you next week.
I'll be honest, I appreciate your manner. I'm not going to do that.